Hello everyone and welcome to our session. This session is for the third secondary year general sciences section. It's a mathematics chapter entitled conditional probability. This is one of the probability chapters you will see this year, and this is our second session in this chapter. In the first session, we explained the following objectives: how to define and calculate the conditional probability, how to define two independent events, and how to use the total probability law. We explained these ideas in details, and today in our session we will do an application on them. First of all, let's go over the concepts we talked about in the first session. So we talked about the conditional probability. We said that the conditional probability, denoted by P of A slash B and red P of A knowing B, it is equal to the probability of the event A, assuming that the event B has already occurred. So we were limiting the outcomes by the event B, and then we were checking the probability of the event A. We say it's the probability of A knowing B. So after we limit the outcomes by the event B, we find the probability of the event A, as if the event B has already occurred, and we're finding the probability of the event A accordingly. We say that P of A knowing B is equal to P of A enter B over P of B, of course with P of B not equal to zero. By this, we get two very important rules. P of A enter B is equal to P of A multiplied by P of B knowing A. And I can switch A and B to get that P of A enter B is equal to P of B multiplied by P of A knowing B. We also talked about independent events. We said that two events are independent when the occurrence of one is not related to the occurrence of the other. So the occurrence of one does not affect the occurrence of the other. In this case, we have P of A knowing B is equal to P of A, and P of B knowing A is equal to P of B. So as you noticed, the occurrence of one of them doesn't change the probability of the other. And a very important result for independent events, we get that P of A enter B is equal to P of A times P of B. Now what about the total probability law? Let A1 to AN be events in a sample space and B an event sharing a part of the outcomes with each of the events A1 to AN. We say that P of B in this case is equal to P of A1 enter B plus P of A2 enter B plus until P of AN enter B. Let's start now with the application exercises. So the first application, the following table represents the distribution of 30 colored balls in a box where each ball is labeled A, B or C. Two balls are selected randomly and simultaneously from this box. Remember that when you see the word simultaneously, it means you need to use combinations. Calculate the number of possible outcomes. So how many possible outcomes do I have? We said this is a combination. How many balls am I selecting? I'm selecting two balls. Out of how many balls? I have a total of 30 balls. So I get a combination of two elements taken from 30. Now part B, calculate the probability of the following events. M, the two balls have the same color. For the two balls to have the same color, they can be either red, and I have 13 red balls in total, or white, and I have 17 white balls. So I have two different types of outcomes. The two balls can be red with a combination of two elements from 13, or the two balls can be white, it's a combination of two elements from 17, over the total number of outcomes, which we already calculated, and it is C of 2 out of 30. Notice that we used plus over here. And why is this plus used? Because the two different outcomes are separate. So I can have an outcome with two red balls or an outcome with two white balls. Now the event N, the two balls are white and labeled C. Now let's check the white balls that are labeled C. I have 6 white balls labeled C. So I need a combination of two balls out of these 6 white balls labeled C. These are the favorable outcomes. over the total number of outcomes, which is C2 from 30. Now, part C, knowing that the two selected balls are white, so it's a conditional probability as soon as you see the word. Knowing that, you must think of conditional probability. Calculate the probability that they are labeled C. So, if I have knowing that the two selected balls are white, it means in the denominator, the outcomes for this event are which ones? They are the white balls, and I have 17 white balls, so I need a combination of two balls out of 17. These are the white balls. And then by fixing these outcomes, I must choose the ones that are labeled C. I have 6, so I have a combination of two elements out of 6. Now part D, knowing that the two selected balls are labeled D, calculate the probability that they have different colors. So first, let's fix the balls labeled B. I must be choosing one from each color. Why? Because I want the balls to have different colors. So I get one ball from the white and one ball from the red. So the probability in this case will be P of different colors, knowing B, is equal to C of 1 from 5 multiplied by C of 1 from 7 over C of 2 from 12. Now, application 2. A bag contains 10 cards numbered 1 through 10. A player will draw 3 cards randomly and simultaneously from this bag. Again, it's a combination. So, the player scores plus 2 for every card numbered 8, 9 or 10. He scores plus 1 for every card numbered 4, 5, 6 or 7. And he scores negative 1 for every card numbered 1, 2, or 3. Calculate the probability of the event. A. The player scores negative 3. The only way by which the player can score negative 3 is when he gets the 3 cards 1, 2, and 3. And he takes negative 1 for each card, which will make a total of negative 3. So the card 1, the card number 2, and the card number 3 must be selected. So it is a combination of 3 from 3, because these are the only options, divided by the total number of outcomes, which is a combination of 3 cards from 10 cards in all. Now, event B, using the same cards, calculate the probability of the event where the player scores 3. So for the player to score 3, he must select 2 cards from the group 8, 9, 10 and 1 card from the group 1, 2, 3. Why? Since if he chooses 2 cards from 8, 9, 10, this will give 4 points. And then 1 card among 1, 2 or 3 will give him negative 1. 4 and negative 1 will make a total of 3. This is one option. Or 3 cards from the group 4, 5, 6, 7. So any 3 cards chosen from these cards will give 1 point each, making a total of 3 points. So the probability of this event in this case will be C2 from 3 times C1 from 3. These are for the first case, where I have 2 cards among 8, 9 and 10 multiplied by 1 card from 1, 2 and 3. This is one outcome with a multiplication in between, plus the other outcome where the 3 selected cards are among the cards from 4 to 7. And of course, I divide by the total number of outcomes, C3 from 10. Now, in part C, calculate the probability of the event the player scores 2. How can the player score 2? So he should select 1 card from each group. Why? Because the first group will give a negative 1, the second group will give a positive 1, so they cancel, and then the third group will give positive 2, so in this case the player will score 2 points. If I select 1 card from each group, I will have C1 from 3, this is for the first group of cards, multiplied by C1 of 4 for the second card, multiplied by C of 1 from 3, this is for the third group of cards, labeled 8, 9 and 10, and all in one outcome, of course divided by the total number of outcomes, C3 from 10. Now, in this part, knowing that the player scores 2, calculate the probability that the 3 cards have even numbers. We already found the event where the player scored 2. So, this part, it's the probability where the player is selecting 1 card from each group, but this card now must have an even number. In the first group, I have 1, 2, and 3. The only even card is 2. In the second group, I have from 4 to 7. I have 2 even cards, 4 and 6, so I need a combination of 1 card from these 2. And in the last group, I have 8, 9 and 10. I have 2 even cards, 8 and 10. I need to be selecting 1 card between these 2 cards. So I get P of even, knowing C, is equal to C of 1 from 1. This is the even card of the first group, multiplied by C of 1 from 2. It's 1 card selected from 4 and 6. Multiplied by C1 from 2 for the third group, and of course divided by the total number of outcomes where the player scores 2. This is the answer we got in the previous part. Application 3, an urn contains 3 white balls and 7 black balls as shown in this figure. A game runs as follows. The player chooses randomly 1 ball from the urn. If the drawn ball is black, the game ends. If the drawn ball is white, he doesn't replace it back, so no replacement in this case, and he chooses a second ball. This process will continue until a black ball is chosen and the game ends. The player wins 10,000 Lebanese pounds for each white drawn ball and nothing for the black ball. What is the probability of the event A? The player wins exactly 10,000 Lebanese pounds. So for the player to win 10,000 Lebanese pounds, of course he must choose 1 white ball followed by 1 black ball for the game to end. The probability of this event in this case will be P of WB, white followed by black. For the white ball, I have 3 over 10. And for the black ball, I have 7 options, 7 black balls, over a total of 9. And why is it 9? Because remember that when he drew the white ball, he didn't replace it back. So this is why the total number of the balls when drawing the second ball will be 9 balls in the urn, which will give the probability of the event a 7 over 30. Part B, calculate the probability of the event. The player wins at least 10,000 Lebanese pounds. So there are many cases in which the player wins a sum of money. It's easier for me in this case to calculate the complement where the player doesn't win at all, and then I do 1 minus the probability of the complement. So I have P of B is equal to 1 minus P of nothing, where the player doesn't win any money, which is when the player gets a black ball at the first draw. It will be 1 minus P of black, and I have 7 black balls in the urn, so the probability of black is 7 over 10, which will give me the probability of the event B to be 3 over 10. Part C, knowing that the first drawn ball is white, what is the probability that the player wins 30,000 Lebanese pounds? So first of all, let W be the event where the first drawn ball is white. So what we have to calculate in this part is the conditional probability P of 30,000 knowing W, where W is that the first drawn ball is white. Let's start with a diagram. We know that to win 30,000 Lebanese pounds, he has to choose 3 white balls and 1 black ball. So if the first drawn ball is white, the second one can be either white or black. I want the player to win 30,000, so he must choose the white also. And the third ball will also be white. Remember that the player will win 10,000 Lebanese pounds for each drawn white ball. And after selecting the 3 white balls, he will only be left with the black balls. For the first ball to be white, I have 3 over 10. For the second ball to be white, if I exclude the first ball, I will be left with 2 over 9. And for the third ball to be white, I will be left with 1 out of 8. And once all the white balls are gone, I will be left with 7 over 7 for the 1 black ball, which will give me a probability of 2 over 9 times 1 over 8 times 7 over 7. Now you might ask, why we didn't take 3 over 10 into consideration in this calculation? Remember that this is a conditional probability. And the first white ball is known. It's already selected. This is why I didn't put it in this rule. And also, if you want to apply the rule of the conditional probability, you will be dividing by the probability of the event W. And the probability of the event W is 3 over 10. This is why it's cancelled from this product. And I get a probability of 1 over 36. These were the application exercises for today. You can find more exercises in your textbook. Thank you for your attention and stay safe, please.